So I got this unit here that's not working. I got some grapes in it. That's the model that it is. All right, so I think that we don't have any fans running, but I'm not sure yet. I'm gonna take those off. But back here, it looks like we've got all this running, but I don't feel any warmth or any cool. I don't feel anything. It's just air moving. That, I can't tell if that's running or not. It feels like it is. I feel some vibration. I was wrong. These are super quiet fans. Alright, my compressor's not running, and you can see my fan is, so don't let that confuse you guys up there in the field. Come across one of these, just because the fan's running doesn't mean the compressor's going to run. So I reset that, and I brought it on. Alright, so this tells me my RLA on my compressor, I believe, is 7. Alright, it's been running for maybe a minute, and I can feel already it's warming up very quickly. This is starting to get hot. This is dirty. They might have tried to clean it, but it's still dirty. So this thing's overheating because of lack of maintenance. Tripped the high pressure switch. Needs to be cleaned, and that's probably about all it needs. It needs to be cleaned good though. So as it runs, I'll keep an eye on my temperature. It looks like it's dropping pretty quickly here. I think it's gonna run fine. I've done enough of these to where I know. I can tell. It's running fine. It's just dirty. Yeah, I wish I had a thermometer. I'd show you guys how warm this was getting, but it's getting there. I'm sure most of you guys already know this, but like in this case, I don't want to check the charge. I don't want to hook up a gauge to it. Maybe like one of these, but I still don't even like that, because just doing that is gonna make it lose a significant amount of refrigerant. You can see here, the total charge is 1.362 pounds, so it's a critical charge. Hooking up a gauge, especially one with hoses, I could lose up to 25-30%. I'm just guessing here, but you know, I don't want to do that, so I'm not gonna disturb the refrigerant circuit. It's starting to get hot now, so after like 20-30 minutes of running, it's gonna be way too hot. So I'm gonna get stuff to get this cleaned and we're gonna clean it. Yeah, see, this thing's running great. It's only been running for like 5 minutes and it's already dropped almost to set point. All right, so my procedure, and everybody's procedure is different, but today my procedure is gonna be water, Viper coil cleaner, a little bit of some brush action, and then I'm gonna straighten out these fins because they're all messed up. Somebody's messed them up a little bit. At least they're not too bad. I'm gonna get this as clean as I can, and that's gonna be how I do it. And you can use many different ways to go. You can do compressed nitrogen and blow it out and make a mess everywhere. You can use a stronger chemical, but see, this is just a really, really dry dust. This is gonna work perfect. I love this stuff. If you've never used it, try it. So on these little self-contained, they're really, really easy to work on. You need to get these clips lifted up on the top to be able to get it out. This thing is kind of in the way. There, that's better. Pull these little clips out, you know, and really get in the condenser. Actually, that's not how you're supposed to do it. You're supposed to pull them out that way. Yep, my bad, guys. Oh yeah, we're gonna get all up in there. And then I'm gonna take the fan assembly loose down here at the brackets. All right, and then it's gonna have two little clips. We got one up there, and one down here. It's loose. Comes out. I have found that in stores, grocery stores and restaurants, you can find these almost everywhere. Can is about perfect for a coil this big. And sorry, I forgot to push play a minute ago before I sprayed it. Be surprised how good this stuff works. It's like fantastic. Just kind of lit. Sit on the coil for a while. Sorry, I'm trying to get good camera work. It's hard, it's a tight spot in here. Got a little bit more left in here. I've used maybe about half the can. Kind of go in the coil, it helps. Oh, I gotta straighten these fins out too, that's right. And these, if you haven't ever used these little fin combs before, you probably have. I think everybody has. You gotta find the right one. And then, I don't know if that's the right one, I thought it was. Best place to test is like on the top of the coil where it's never been messed up or hurt or damaged. Alright, so this is close, but it's not the right one. Right on top of a tube actually is perfect. Just want to line it up. See, that's not the one either. There it is. Got it. Finally got it. So when it fits, like, it'll fit perfect and you'll know it. That's the one. Alright, I'm gonna try to video this at the same time that I do it. Or I'm gonna set my camera down. Hopefully it gets it. Yeah, hopefully it gets it. But you wanna go easy with it. Kinda take your time. And you gotta make sure that you get it in there and it slides in, right? And once it slides in, you can go all the way through it, and you can get some really bad damage out with this, with these things. I've used these a lot. See, it's in a real difficult spot to be able to do this easily. You don't have to rinse this stuff off at any specific time either. Like, you can let it sit on there as long as you want. Sometimes when they're bent really, really bad, you gotta like get them out with something else first, but be careful not to poke and puncture the coil, of course. Like, I trust myself. I know I'm not gonna puncture the coil. Or at least I hope I know. You never know sometimes, I guess, right? Like that little spot right there, you wanna just kinda get it out a little bit. Same kinda like over here. Anywhere that the coil curls under, like right there, also, you want to get that straightened out. Because the little plastic comb can only do so much, you know? But see all this nasty stuff that's hiding in there? Look at that. Kind of just work it. No, a little bit at a time. Go over it twice if you have to. Or however many times you need to go over it. Just do it. Whatever, you know? See what I mean about those, like when they roll in, curl in? I don't know, maybe I just like stuff to be perfect. Once you get the feel for this, it gets pretty easy. And it's like, whenever you see these coils like this, like, man, I gotta fix that, you know? What do you call it? Finesse. You just gotta have some finesse. That's all. I had an old boss. He used to say that. You just need some finesse. Gotta make sure you get it in the lines, in the grooves right, because if you don't, and you go up with it like that, you really mess up some of the accomplishments you've already made. And it sucks. You feel cheated. See, like right there, I need to assist like that. It's too much for the little plastic comb. I can't handle it. So I straighten it out a little bit with this little pick I got. See, also down here. just make sure you have your finesse in order so you don't poke the coil. Sometimes it takes a while to get these back in line. I think that's pretty good there. It's gonna be my last little bit of coil cleaner, so that's gonna be my last spray. Be careful and cut yourself real easy on these. They're still the same sharp coils that they were when you first learned they were sharp. I know, I need a pump up shit, I know. See, I'm trying not to make a mess. I'm trying to get it all going in this pan. That's the idea here. See that damn coil? Cut me. Didn't cut me deep enough to bleed, but it still cut me. Me again, goddammit. There, I don't know why the hell I didn't put gloves on in the first place. I did, but I took them back off because I had to do something. Anyways, you sit here and hand pump spray the whole time if you want, if you don't have a pump up sprayer. Or just take the top off the bottle. This isn't even really that bad of a chemical. You can just like do this, and then really that's like enough. You don't even gotta do much more. Look how nasty that shit is, man. Don't wanna do too much anyways, because this pan won't hold but like maybe a gallon or two. And I don't wanna get the sales floor wet, you know? Probably gonna get one more refill on this and that's it. Yeah, that's good enough for me. Alright, so I'm putting it back together. I'm gonna put this thing right here back in first by sliding the bottom. Make sure that the bottom goes down and in. There's like a little there's a specific way that it goes. Here, I can show you here. Alright, so see that goes on the inside, and then this here goes on the upside.
Yeah.
Like that.
Okay.
Then you get your clips and you hook onto the top. All right, like that. And then you come down with it, and this freaking thing is in the way, so I can't really show you that well, but it's really simple to do this, except when it's in a tight spot like this. The other one. Hook onto the top, go down, and then over there on that side,
push it back in. Yeah. Just like that.
And yeah, so for these, it's like totally up to y'all how you want to do yours, but I'm taking mine off and I'm taking it to the sink. You gotta be really careful with these things because they're really fragile right here, especially when they get older. It'll break really, really easy. But if you can manage to get it off without breaking it, these are the only things, these four little clips right there are the only things holding it. And then these ones on the circle kind of hold it centered on the motor. So then I just brush off my motor with whichever brush. And then I take my fan guard and fan blade to the nearest sink.
Do it.
It's back. Now we're at 66. It's gonna go down quick. Right there in the serial number, the MY21, that's the year, but then you can also see the manufacture date right there too. Take like 5 minutes to get down to set point. If it ever had a back cover, it was missing. It wasn't here when I got here, so. Yeah, look at that. It's literally been like 4 minutes. Okay, and that is it. I'm done. I'm finished. We're all good. So, see you guys on the next one. Thanks for watching.